Hello everyone, welcome to the demo of our LinkBoss tools. First, we will give a brief introduction to each tool and then we will demonstrate how to use them. We have divided our tools into two main categories, link building and reports. Let's start with a short introduction to the link building tools. The inbound tool. This tool helps you add internal links to any of your pages. You can also view existing link metrics and manage them from here. Outbound tool. Similar to the inbound tool, the outbound tool lets you add outbound links and build a balanced link profile. Silo tool. This tool allows you to create and manage silos for your site. It's especially useful if you have pillar pages and want to experiment with different silo structures. Archive silo tool. Designed specifically for archive pages like categories, authors, and tags, this tool is ideal for e-commerce sites looking to optimize link structures for product categories. Custom network tool. If your site is built around topic clusters instead of a pillar post structure, the custom network tool is a great option for managing and linking your content. Bulk tool. The bulk tool enables you to generate contextual links for up to 100 pieces of content in just a minute. It uses the smart internal link generator to create a contextual heading and paragraph. It supports Gutenberg and Classic Editor. Bulk 2.0 tool. This is an upgraded version of the original bulk tool, developed in response to user feedback. It does everything the bulk tool does. In addition, it allows you to add relevant sentences to the closest paragraph and works with all the major page builders. Anchor Manager. The Anchor Manager allows you to view and edit all your anchor texts and links directly from one place. Now, let's move on to the report tools. Site report. It shows important metrics like the total number of internal and external links, orphan posts, and more, all in a single dashboard. Links report. The links report lets you track inbound, outbound, external links per post. You can easily delete links or add new ones from here. Site visualizer. This tool visualizes your site's entire interlinking structure. In future updates, you'll be able to design and adjust this structure directly through the visualizer. After adding the site, you should first check the site report. Check the number of posts and make sure all of them are synchronized. Then we suggest you start with orphan pages. If there are too many pages, you can use the bulk interlinking tool. However, you can also use the silo or inbound tool. We will use the bulk tool 2.0. Let's give you a short demo of how the tool works. On the right-hand panel, you can see the categories. When you click the Fetch button, it brings the posts in the category. You can use the toggle button to fetch the orphan posts only. Click Add Orphans and you will see all the orphan posts. When you click the Submit button, it finds relevant posts for each of these pages to interlink from. So the bulk linking table is here. It has found the target pages from which to get links for all the articles. For demonstration purposes, I will interlink just a few from here. You can add your own anchor text or let the tool choose its own. I will add anchor text for one. Click Submit. The bulk process has been initiated. It's done. Hit the refresh button. You can see the contents have been updated. Let's check if this worked. Here's the anchor text. Looks all right. Let's explore the silo tool. We'll create a silo for snapping turtles. Click the search button to get suggestions for support articles. We will select 5. We can create different types of links in the silo by connecting support to pillar, pillar to support, and support to support. For now, we will just click Submit. Let's visualize the silo. Let's create another silo. We'll create a silo for box totals. We will select 5 support articles. This time I will select support to pillar, pillar to support, and support to support links. I'm choosing randomly. Let's visualize the silo. It now looks like a proper silo. There are a few different methods to build a silo. The first method is to build the links one by one. It gives you 100% control over the silo. These are the sentences from your existing content. Let's select this one, click update. The link has been created. Now, suppose you don't like the suggested sentences. In that case, you can choose a smart link generator. These are your target paragraphs. The generated paragraph will appear after the target paragraph. Let's go with this paragraph. Select an anchor text and click paragraph. This is the generated paragraph with the anchor text. You can edit it if you want. Let's click update. The link has been created. Now you can also automate the silo process using the boss mode. With boss mode, all the silo links will be created at once using the smart internal link generator version 2.0. This means it will add a few relevant sentences after the most semantically relevant paragraph for each post. We have to wait a few moments. You can leave the page if you want and do other tasks. The process will run in the background. The process is now complete. Let's visualize the silo now. The silo looks great. You can also edit the silo and add more posts. Let's add another support article. You can add the structure for the new one. You can also change the structure for the old ones. Let's run the boss mode again. The additional support links have been created. That's how you can easily complete and edit your silos. The automation feature is available in Archive Silo and Custom Network tool as well. Those who don't want to use the silo and have topic clusters, for that I will use the Custom Network tool. Click Create. Here you can create topic clusters based on keywords. Suppose I want to create a network based on painted turtles. On the right-hand panel, you will find the suggestions. Let's add 5 articles for the demonstration. For each post, you can select as many as you want. Click the Submit button. The network has been created. The content cluster looks like this. Let's create a link. Though the given sentences are relevant, we will use an alternative method for demonstration purposes. We will use a smart internal link generator here. This will generate a paragraph that's relevant to the topic to create an interlink. These are some relevant paragraphs from existing content. You have to select one of them, and the tool will generate a paragraph after this one to create an interlink. You can choose your anchor text from the suggestions or use a custom one. I'm going to use this one. Click the paragraph button. This is the generated paragraph with the anchor text. This is the selected paragraph, and the generated paragraph will appear after this paragraph. We will click the update button. The link's been placed. As you can see, the paragraph's been added along with the anchor text. You can see the link in the network. We will show you how to use the inbound tool. Let's go to reports and find an orphan page. It doesn't have any links. The inbound tool will suggest to you the posts you can link from. It will also show the semantic similarity score. If you click on the link, you will see the relevant sentences from the existing content that you can use to create links. Otherwise, you can generate a paragraph using the smart link generator. This one looks good to me. If you hover on this icon, you will see the relevancy score of the sentence. Click the update button. The link's been placed. As you can see, the link has been created. Now, if you don't like the suggested sentences, you can use a smart link generator. Here, you can see the more relevant paragraphs from the content. We will choose this anchor text. Click paragraph. This is the generated paragraph. We will update. As you can see, the paragraph has been placed along with the anchor text. Now we will show how to use the outbound link tool. You can create outbound links from the outbound link tool or the reports. This one has zero outbound links. Click the plus sign. You can add links directly from here. It works the same as the inbound tool. Let's look at the archive silo tool. Click the create button. This one is to create silos for categories. For example, let's take red year sliders. You can paste the category URL here. Use this box to help you find the most relevant posts for this category. On the right hand panel, you will find the suggestions. Let's select 5 articles. Click submit. The network has been created. Now you can build links just like before. Let's check out the anchor manager. Here you will find all the anchor text used on your site. These are the anchor text distributions. If you click here, you will learn what each classification means. We can easily check the anchor texts from here. You can edit the anchor text directly from here. I will edit this one just for demonstration purposes. After editing, you can check the relevancy score. You can also change the target URL if you want. Click update. The anchor text has been updated. You can also delete any anchor text from here. Done. Site report. It shows important metrics like the total number of internal and external links, orphan posts, and more, all in a single dashboard. Links report. The links report lets you track inbound, outbound, external links per post. You can easily delete links or add new ones from here. Site visualizer. This tool visualizes your site's entire interlinking structure. In future updates, you'll be able to design and adjust this structure directly through the visualizer. That's all for today.